Katie Linendoll here at Toy Fair New York. And you know, there's some people you meet in life and in the industry that just have that pop. Whoa, pun intended. I did not do that on purpose.
I know, you are, it's off the top of your head, it's amazing.
Brian Mariotti, Funko, always a very popular booth, whether it's Comic-Con or here at Toy Fair, and just so much excitement going on. Like, as soon as I came in here, I just wanted to talk to you and hear the latest and greatest. And of course, there's so much going on. Where do we start? Where do you want to start?
Wow. BTS. I mean, I know nothing about K-pop, but I guess there is a large portion of the world that is obsessed with K-pop. First ones to get the license, first ones to have the product out in the marketplace. And then yesterday we did all our social media exposure of all the new stuff at Toy Fair. Post Malone, BTS, and The Office. Those were the ones that it seemed like grabbed the attention on a global basis of what we're releasing for 2019.
Yep.
Super exciting. But BTS, who would have thought we'd be talking K-pop 18 months ago?
It's so huge.
It is.
I just had a friend come back from Korea and said that it was everywhere. I mean, it's everywhere. It's everywhere.
Yes, yes.
Crazy.
I know.
And then I have to say, I get an urgent text the other night. Just that, you know, there's something for everyone. We've talked about that, on the, especially on the pop side. And I get this urgent text from a colleague that is just a really professional executive. And he's like, Katie, help. I like how I'm like a friend of Funko, as you've deemed it. I need the Muhammad Ali.
Yes.
Get them all.
Yes.
It's so neat to see what comes out and who it's going to appeal to.
Yeah.
And like you said, Office was big, BTS was big. Anything else happening on the toy or just 2019 side that you're excited to announce?
Man, 2019 is a perfect wave in Huntington Beach where it's sunny, but the sun's going down and you get like a 9-foot wave that's just perfectly breaking and you're on the board at the right time and you're paddling and you catch that wave. New Star Wars movie, new Frozen movie, Avengers Infinity War sequel, Captain Marvel looks freaking amazing, Brie Larson, also known as Envy Adams from Scott Pilgrim fame, Game of Thrones coming back on,
Toy Story 4,
what, Stranger Things Season 3, Rick and Morty's coming back. It just feels like all the stars are aligning and there's so many amazing, really important pieces of fandom all colliding in 2019. I love what we're doing. And of course, all that we're doing as usual. But it's a special year. I mean, you don't get years like this very often. I've never, in 15 years of running Funko, never seen a year like this content-wise. We're insanely excited.
15 years.
I know, boy, the gray is showing the 15 years.
No, you're looking hip as ever. You know it. I have to talk to you about the Pez side because that's a side that's near and dear to my heart. And I love that you've just kind of injected, as a Pez fan my whole life, there's something a little, I mean, we talked about pop, that's where we started this conversation. You give it a little oomph into that line, and I think that's been really neat.
I think it's fun as a diehard pest collector like you are, so, hey.
We don't have enough time to go into the collection and the pieces. He literally has buyers out there.
Yes.
Looking for all.
Yes.
Especially on the vintage side.
It's one man can't do it all. I need an army of people out there scouring for all the things that I didn't think I needed, but then I realized I needed.
Can you tell them one thing that you have that's like,
so I just got a wonderful Disney 1967 Epcot Center Disney display of all the cool Mickey Mouses and Donald Ducks and Goofies that was made for the parks for 1967, mint unopened counter display that had 24 pieces inside. Still in there are mint cellophane wrappers and all the original comics and all the original candies from 1967. Beautiful, beautiful artwork. So cool to be the first person to open that thing up and unfold that Epcot flat and see Walt Disney World on that. So that was those kind of moments, man. It makes the collecting hobby so worth it. And they don't happen a lot, and they don't happen very often. But when they do, they mean a ton to me. So.
And these countertops, as you call them.
Yeah.
You've purchased quite a few now.
Yeah, yeah. So
that's
we've got
a whole other.
It is. It's a whole different other way to collect Pez instead of just individual units because if you collect too many of those, it becomes a little bit of noise, and you need things to break up the collection. And I always loved point-of-sale purchase displays. And so counter displays have beautiful artwork, and get to see what Pez was thinking back in 67 or 72 or 75 and what that would look like when they gave it to a retailer and they put that on the counter to entice people to buy Pez. And I think there's something special and unique about that, and it breaks up your collection in a really special way. So for me, that's always been the one part of the Pez collection hobby that's meant the most to me, is finding the Batman with cape from 1972 that has 24 mint Batman capes all in their original cellophane. That kind of stuff is crazy to me, and I love it.
But that speaks to now how you're working with Pez. You have to have that history and that appreciation from where you started to get to where you are now.
I think Pez realized they're dealing with a nut job when it comes to me. They realize how much I love their brand. I might love their brand more than they love their brand. But I think for collectors like us, you always think about, I love Pez, but why didn't Pez do Jack Skellington? It's crazy to think that Pez didn't do Jack Skellington, but now with the Pop Pez collaboration, Jack Skellington and Oogie Boogie are there with Lock, Shot, Stock, and Barrel, and what other things, Huckleberry Hound and Wally Gator, and oh my gosh, we're doing Caddyshack Pez, something that Pez probably wouldn't do. And those are the things that I think that for me, this relationship's been so special with Pez, is how do we fill in the gaps for Pez collectors on beloved properties and fandoms that they will never see represented. And I think Pez has embraced us as like, yep, that's something that's very niche, very collector-based, scales up a little bit in age, and that's something we probably wouldn't do, and so that's a great partnership with Funko.
But even like to bring in a whole new audience, because I remember when the Golden Girls Pez came out, which was awesome, you know, today's show is like, can we possibly do something on it? Like, you're bringing in a whole other audience that gets excited about.
It is, and I think it's something that's helping add to what Pez is and how important it is to me growing up, and how important it is for people who have been collecting Pez for 40, 50 years. Let's fill in some gaps. Let's do some special fun things to bring more people into the Pez world. And maybe we hook them with a Pop Pez, but get them to also collect regular Pez as well.
Awesome stuff. I know you're a busy man. I see you're getting pulled in 50,000 directions. So thank you, Brian, as always, for chatting. And we'll be in touch.
We'll
have more to come on the Funko side.
Awesome.
Brian Mariotti, Katie Linendoll, stay tuned.
Thank you.